applications of Biot Savart's law. Applications of Biot Savart law. Whenever the current is passing through a conductor, around the conductor there is a magnetic field. Such a magnetic field is called induced magnetic field. The strength of the magnetic field can be calculated by Ampere circuit law and Biot-Savart's law. Whenever the straight current carrying conductor is there, Ampere circuit law is used. Whenever zigzag conductor is there, Ampere Biot-Savart's law is used. Right? In the case of circular current carrying conductor, in the case of solenoid, in the case of conductor with a finite length, we want to apply the Biot-Savart's law in order to calculate the magnetic field induction. In the first case, the magnetic field induction at the center of the current carrying circular loop. What is the magnetic field induction? In the applications of Biot-Savart's law, magnetic field induction at the center of the current carrying circular loop. Current carrying circular loop. Now, this is current carrying circular loop. This is the current carrying circular loop. Right? Now, what is the center? This is the center. What is the radius? This is the radius capital R. Now, what is the current passing through this one? I is the current passing through this one. Now, this is called current carrying circular loop. At the center, what is the magnetic field induction? That can be calculated by using Biot-Savart law. What is the Biot-Savart law? B is equals to integration of mu naught I by 4 pi dl bar cross r bar by r cube. This is called, what to say, vector form. Now, vector form. Now, what is the scalar form? B is equals to integration of mu naught by 4 pi I dl sin theta by r square. This is called scalar form. Right? Now, this current carrying circular loop is treated as zigzag conductor. Now, for understanding purpose, already I said, this is called, what to say, length of the conductor, total length of the conductor. If the total length of the conductor is divided into number of infinitesimal parts, right, only one of the conductor, a portion of the conductor, a small portion of the conductor is represented by dl. Now, this is represented by dl. Now, length dl. Right? If you add all the dls, what you are going to get? L. Mathematically, right, the integration of dl is represented by L. Next. Suppose, let us consider the same wire is turned like this. same wire is turned into like this, same length, but it is formed into a circle of radius r, of circle radius r. Similarly, it is also divided into number of infinitesimal parts, number of infinitesimal parts, right? A small length is represented by dl, right? That is, by adding all the lengths, by adding all the lengths, you are again getting L. But you are adding circularly along a closed loop, then it is called circle. Now this length is equals to closed loop, this length is equals to circumference of the circle, that is called 2 pi r. Right? If the coil has n turns, if the coil has n turns, or let us consider capital N turns, therefore closed integral of dl is equals to, that is what to say, 2 pi r into n. This is one concept. Now what is our topic? This is called current carrying circular coil. At the center, what is the magnetic field induction? For the sake of this one, I want to choose a current element. Now this is called current element. This is the current, small current element. It is represented by, what to say, IDL. It is a vector quantity. Now current element to the point O, what is the perpendicular distance? This is the perpendicular distance, capital R. Now this is called current element. Now this is the point where we are calculating the magnetic field. What is the line joining between these two? This is the line joining between these two. This is the line joining between these two. Now this current element, this line, both are perpendicular. Therefore theta is equals to 90 degrees. Now here in this case, B is equals to closed integral of 4 pi into I dl. What is the theta here? 90, sine 90 by, what to say, r square. Therefore mu naught by 4 pi is getting out, right? I is also getting out. Now dl by, what to say, r square. Now sine 90 is equals to 1, therefore I is there, dl is there. Now here in this case, that is mu naught by 4 pi, mu naught by 4 pi into 1 by, that is what to say, right, small r, radius is capital R. Now radius is capital R, here is also what to say, capital R square. Here is also what to say, capital R square. Here is also capital R square. Now that is what to say, dl. That closed integral of dl, it is a circle, it is closed. Then if the coil has n turns, 2 pi r into n. Therefore here that equals to mu naught I by 4 pi into I by capital R square into dl, right? Now mu naught by 4 pi into I 1 by r square, this term is equals to 2 pi r into n. Therefore now pi gets cancelled, 2 2 2 1 ja 2 2 ja gets cancelled, r 1 ja, right, like this. Therefore what to say, mu naught by 2 into, what to say, here I is forgotten, by what to say, number of turns n, what to say, 2r. Therefore B is equals to, that is mu naught I n by, that is 2r. This is the magnetic field expression at the center of the magnetic field induction.